just a 12. Sit Gimel Tach. Had Hogas Besach Yisei. How a person has to conduct himself when he goes into the Besach Yisei. It doesn't mean when you do your Bible approaches, but first off, all this, because it's a location which, you know, this whole discussion. No. When you ever go into a Chassidish house, the sink is not in the same location where the bathroom is, where the toilet is. It's like, so when I first bought my house in Muncie, I bought it first when it was built for a Chassidish person, you know, they lived there for 2 years. So, when you go out of the bath toilet area, you barely go into it, like there was a door separating the two. Because they don't wash their hands in the same location where you have the toilet. Because in Halacha, there's a ruach tumah. Because you can't wash hands, because there's a contaminated spirit, so if you wash hands, you're accomplishing nothing. Cleanliness you could accomplish, but in terms of ruach tumah, you're not accomplishing. But it's cited in Halacha, you know, in the old days, what was it? It was an outhouse. So because all the waste was there, so that waste, that level of uncleanliness generates the ruach tumah. Like, that's what generates it. But today that everything is flushed away, it's not there, the ruach tumah doesn't. But the chassidim namachmi, I mean, the Rav Henkin is so makel to such a degree that he holds that if the toilet area is clean and the toilet is closed, you could even say a bracha in there. That's a Rav Henkin holds. Because everything immediately, it's not there. There used to be what's called a Persian toilet, and not the Persians. They were architects. And they built bridges. They were very good when it came to the angles. So the way they made their toilets, they had water running in them. It was always on a slant. It was in the diagonal. So it never stayed, the waste never stayed below. It was always washed away to some other location. So there's the whole discussion, because it's not there, does it assume the status of this unclean location? Because it's this galgal. Immediately, it's like, washes out, it rolls away right away, immediately. Okay? So this whole thing that we say, you know, it's not respectful. You say to the malachim, you accompany the person. Today we don't. You take leave of the malachim. You ask him to wait for you until you finish doing your bodily functions. Okay, we're holding halacha base, page 12. Yehid tzanua beisakise. The person, when you do your bodily functions, you should do it in a modest way. Be modest. V'lo yigala atzma chiyishet. So how does one act modestly? You should not expose yourself until you sit down. Sometimes you go to these rest stops today, I don't know, but, you know, the one time they didn't have doors on them. They didn't have doors on them. You saw the way certain people, like literally, they have no semblance of almost of humanity when they go in there. They expose themselves, whatever they do there. You know, you can't even talk about it the way. But again, a Jew should not expose himself until he's sitting. Hagol lo yelchu shnei anoshim yachad. I mean, we'll see. It's based on a Gemara in Shkolim. You know, you're not supposed to speak. You're not supposed to speak, especially when you do your bodily functions. When you're actually doing your bodily functions, when you even urinate, you're not supposed to speak. Urinal, you know, having a conversation, you know, while they're both urinating. It's contrary to the halacha. You're not supposed to. Bodily functions for sure not. It's based on the Gemara. And there's no question, what about speaking when you're not doing it, just in that area? Again, because we spoke to the ruach tumah, it's not a location you speak. You don't speak in that location. Gam lo yedaber shom tremo. One should not speak there. Lo yedaber shom. He doesn't say when you do it, you're doing your bodily functions. You should not speak. And we're not speaking because he's speaking a Lashon HaKodesh, because he's speaking Hebrew. V'yizkor adelus badum shem tzniyus. When you go, you should close the door. For modesty, don't leave the door open. shaving very often were found in locations that had uncleanliness, extreme levels of uncleanliness. So Mara's, the Gemara speaks about, it's Gemara in Shkolin, and in Gemara, he went in, he was part of the functions, and, you know, he was concerned, because the Gemara says if you have two people, the shame will not harm you. Two people, they will, if you're by yourself, you can be harmed. Two, not. So the Gemara was sitting there, so his wife was outside, so he asked his wife to put her hand on his head while he was doing his bodily, and that, they didn't speak, no conversation. So by keeping her hand on his head, it's as if there were two people in there. To go in there with him, not, you know, it's just not appropriate. But to her hand being on his head, it's as if she's there. It's just equivalent to two people, so he's protected. He's protected from the shaving. But again, body closed, don't be shum tzinius. Meaning, you know, this is all, like I would say, you know, the fifth head of the children of the temple is disabled. Let's see, I'm an older person. Not able, you know, he does his best. We're speaking about you should be as modest as you can be. That's what it means. Person who's difficult, so he's doing his best. It says the same. When you stand, also, you shouldn't be exposed. Here, he says, if one is afraid, one could extend his hand through the window, keep it on his head. He shouldn't see his hand. But you have to know when a child go in. It's not, but it's aimbo das. Certain halachas. Cited halacha in Ezra, you know, when a person has relations with his wife. You have a child in the room. The child is awake. Is it appropriate? Not appropriate. If it's an infant, it's not a problem. Decided love, okay, if the child could speak, the child should not be in the room. If the child's awake, it could cause actually damage. The child could actually be damaged. Emotionally and mentally damaged by it. Right? So it says, Achim Kodin Sheimbo Das, Mutali Kodes. Meaning, Eimbo Das. It seems to be, but if he has a semblance of, you know, das doesn't mean he has to be bar mitzvah. You know, intelligence. He understands. Lo yidabedu dimutzorach godol. You hear this? He says, what about if it's something great necessity you have to speak? Efshe demutal dabe kol zman she'im nifnen adayim. If the person has to start believing himself while you're doing your bodily function, you should not speak. Avo beishe nifne av l'tzorach godol osor. We're not talking about it's a question of safety. We're talking about the Torah, it's a great necessity. What if he's not able to close, somebody's about to come, and you want to indicate to the other person that somebody's in there, you should only make noises. Okay? Not to speak. What a woman. Women at work, because there's a question of seclusion, not permitted to express itself with a woman. Somebody may come in, there are women there. Shall Yishma call them Yibachutz, that people from the outside today, women are speaking, so therefore they will not go in there. Lo Yichnos Ish Shal Dusham Yisyachir Imoim, it's a question of Yichud. Mashkas the Nechnosis Gabkein Bishtaim Bebesakisei. Oh, it seems to me that two women are permitted because it says they can speak with one. What? Okay. I mean, Chazonir, his wife ran a store. Somebody, she sold the material, textiles. And very often, husband wasn't there. He was they would know that her husband's not there. She felt, you know, she didn't feel safe. So she would always say, his name is Avraham Yeshaya, Avraham Yeshaya. So he always would say, she was like, as if he'd be in the back room, she'd be calling him and having a conversation with him. That the goyim should think that he's in the back room. Right? For that reason, so if a woman's by herself, she would also hear people, the people, it's supposed to be an indication of genius, people, they speak to themselves. You know? Before the doctor puts more medication. Okay? He used to say, how do we help you? A half a genius, half crazy. That's what he used to say. That's premedication. Okay. No, that the whole idea, it will prevent yichud. If a man would know there's a woman there, he's not going to go in there. But let's say a person, all of a sudden, he doesn't realize, goes in, and there's a woman there. So it creates a situation of yichud. Okay? So today, things have changed. In terms of people to speak there, things are a little different. Because today, everything is washed away, but regarding the actual doing one's bodily functions, that's a whole different discussion. When a person does his bodily function, one should not speak. One should not speak. Let's see, there's a small pair of locha over here. Yitzanuach. I am Brochus, Sam of Bez on Bez, from an Alpha on Bez, the Mapnik, Agmoro, the Midas Atzneus. The Gemara speaks over there at a very extensive level of how important it is to be modest. Ubesmak Moret Sneus, Lemitze Doraiso. That a person has to conduct himself in a modest way, it's a mitzvah Doraiso according to the Smak. Risi Bezum Komesh, Shemes Atzlin, Bibnias, Bezakisi Dorabim. He said to certain communities, they're somehow, they're not responsible, they don't build a public location, public bathroom. Israel is there coming with sholos and because they have the problems. Shomvach chosa al yideze midas atzniyus, oboin al yideze lakam mechsholim. The many problems arise. You have a public location where people go there to do their bodily functions or whatever it is. Firstly, he says it avoids many pitfalls, problems in the community. Aleph, Kamameos, Brochos, Shemes Kadoshin, Skorum Cholesh, Vatola, Aydezer. Now, you know, later in the discussion, you know, you say Kiddush Levona once a month. Last night, I'm not sure if everybody said Kiddush Levona. So in Europe, you had open sewers in the street. So you're not permitted to say a Brocho within four amos of waste. Human waste, and you had it running along, literally along the street, near the curb. You had literally, you had sewers, open sewers. So if you have open sewers, you're not going to say a bracha. So later, it's a whole discussion. You go on the street, you say, Kiddush going out in the street. So you're within the proximity of the waste. You're not permitted to say a bracha. So there's the whole discussion. If you're out of the dollar ups, you'd be facing in its direction. Anything which you think within your eye range is considered within the dollar amos. So you have to turn your back. What about if it's aligned, you're facing in the same direction, but you're not looking at it. Meaning it's running in the same direction. Meaning if you turn your face, you could see it. If you have to literally turn your back, right? Or let's say you'd be parallel with it. Right? So later these discussions. So you're out of dollar amos. But if you turn your face slightly, you'd be able to see it. Of course, there's no question. There's a stench, you smell it, and it has, and the waste is there. It's like it's within your 4 cubits. You're not permitted. But these are problems. If it's contained in the structure, it's contained in the structure. But if it's people relieve themselves in the street or in the open, it becomes a problem with brochas. Everybody agrees. Yeah, it's a real b'diavad. You're supposed to say, you're supposed to love the sky. When you say, l'chat chila. But otherwise, you have to visually, the window should be open. Even though glass is transparent, you see the moon, the window should be open. That you should, there should be no interruption between what you see and the moon. Kiddush Livona. Some people, the machmir, they even take off their glasses. They take off their glasses. Is it different when you wear glasses or the windows closed? No, because the whole idea, you're in a different, the whole idea, you're not exposed to it. Basically, you're in another structure. And the window closed, it's like you're totally sealed off from that location. No? The glasses, you're there, you're in the location. The glass is magnified with it, you should be able to see it better. But where are you? Right? You're in the location where the moon is shining on that location. No glasses, you can say it's not part of your body though. The many yochel atzmo, lamor al atzmo shir shov v'chamesh tfilos otoevo. He says other reasons. He mentions this, that if a person has to, let's say, daven, and it's you're not able to contain yourself what it takes to walk 4 mil, which is 72 minutes, right? The halacha is the tefillah of the Shemoneh Esrei is toeva. It's toeva, it's considered an abomination. So if you have a public location, people don't withhold themselves until they get home or until they go outside of the community. But if not, it's a question of all the Shemoneh Esrei has no value. People go daven, they're not able to contain themselves. And one time, you never had a, before you had indoor plumbing. In the shul itself, you never had a bathroom. You had to do it somewhere else. Out in the field, out in the community, the Maran Brachos, like the Pesach of Mishlei, that, and it, one interpretation is that fortune is a person, and the question, what is it? That he has the location where he needs himself within the proximity of his table, near his home. Because normally you'd have to go out into the field to do your bodily functions. But if you have it within the proximity of home, because Gemara says that most illnesses come, Gemara says on Shabbos, that if you eat where you did not relieve yourself, and you eat, it's very unhealthy. Very unhealthy. You should always relieve yourself before you eat. We're talking about where you have a sense, you have an urge to relieve yourself, and the person can't, and he eats. Very unhealthy. So therefore, fortune is the one who is able to relieve himself where it's not far from his table. Otherwise, the person withholds himself because it's a tremendous inconvenience to go far out and then come back. To be continued. Under the gutter. Come on. No. So there it's in the city. Well, it's amazing. It's just an indication how much knowledge is contained. We touch upon so much, whether it's medicine, whether it's behavior, whether it's just knowledge in general, you're exposed to so many different things. Lamathes Mavokas, it's all about, right? 39 creative activities, what do you touch upon? Everything is a creative activity, whether it's plowing, it's agriculture, whether it's weaving, whether it's dyeing, I mean, everything. Whether it's processing, construction. Okay?